League baseball history. It's been a great.
That's outside.
We start the bottom of the fifth inning, and the lead is three now for the Dodgers. After the two teams just traded three-run shots, Gurriel for the Astros, Cody Bellinger for the Dodgers. 2-0 now on Marwin Gonzalez. Again, another uncharacteristically long inning for Kershaw. Not batting, of course, in the American League, so fidgeting in the dugout. His team has given him another three-run lead. And he's gone 3-0 on the leadoff hitter. He issued a leadoff walk last inning. A one-out hit by Altuve, an RBI double by Correa, and a three-run home run by Gurriel. We'll have more on Gurriel and his last couple of days with Ken Rosenthal next time he comes up. 3-0. Marwin Gonzalez will not curry favor with the home plate umpire by walking away on that pitch. High strike. False start, offense, number 22.
Tell he's grinding, trying to get back in that rhythm.
3-1. Gonzalez skies it into left, carrying back to the track. One out in the fifth. Well, there is Stephen Moyer, Sean Teal, and Blair Redford from The Gifted. The new Marvel series on Fox. Critics are saying it's everything an X-Men TV show should be. Check out an all-new episode of The Gifted tomorrow at 9 Eastern, 8 Central, right here on Fox. And then the following night, we'll have Game 6 of this World Series.
That's right. We talked about watching that tomorrow. We got a day off.
We did. Here's McCann. Strike on the outside corner.
No, it's inside.
Probably be better to watch in your Hall of Fame suite.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's more room. There's more room. 1-1 to McCann. That's down the line, hooking. Tell you a couple of loud connections. One by Gonzalez that he hit straight up to the track and left a moment ago, and that one just curled to the wrong side of the foul pole for the Astros. Inside corner, two out, and McCann knew it. Just the second strikeout for Kershaw after he K'd 11 in game one. Tonight's telecast is sponsored by T-Mobile. This postseason, there's a new leader in network, T-Mobile, America's best unlimited network. And by Steal a Base, Steal a Taco, only at Taco Bell. Our producer Pete Macheska, our director Matt Gangle. Glad you're with us tonight on Fox with Kenny Rosenthal, Tom Verducci, field level, Joe Buck, and John Smoltz.
Well, then I'll see it, please.
Ball one as that skips in to George Springer.
That's the pitch that kind of disappeared there for a while, the curveball. Talked about when he's hit with that pitch, it's much more difficult to kind of hone in on one area of the plate as a hitter.
Outside.
That was Kershaw yelling at himself after that pitch missed down and away. He's frustrated.
Yeah, and he's so good at being able to get back into the strike zone when he wants to. This was instant.
Two, one.
Clayton will be happy that his Dallas Cowboys won today on the road at Washington.
He's probably relaxing in the clubhouse watching that game. That's a good time killer.
Two-one delivery, Springer. Ball three.
Typically, at this point in the game, if Dave Roberts and your horse has a three-run lead, you're feeling great, but you're also reading your pitcher to see if that feeling stays the same before you have to get the bullpen up.
A very tired bullpen. That's a strike, and Springer comes back.
Been on both sides, so I mean both teams have had this side of the plate to deal with. I'd be stuck right there as a pitcher. I would just be keep going right there.
So you have to be able to hit it, meaning that spot.
Yeah.
3-2. The lines of what you were just talking about, Kenta Maeda is getting loose.
Yeah, he's just out of sorts just a little bit and forcing the action. Obviously we've seen him yell at himself and disappointment.
3-2. Foul. Dallas Keuchel, the starter for Houston, went 3 2/3 through 86 pitches. This next pitch will be pitch number 84 for Clayton Kershaw. And it's another 3-2 delivery to Springer. Oh. He walked him. Every hitter that's walked tonight has come around to score. That includes Springer last inning. He led off with a walk. Here's Bregman, who homered off Kershaw in game one. Here comes Rick Honeycutt, who's been in that pitching coach position for the Dodgers for 12 years. So they will talk on the mound, and we will give you a quick word from T-Mobile.
Good in that 6 seconds getting that in there.
This is tailor-made for a mound visit. Kershaw trying to get through five, and he's got Bregman standing in his way. Bregman could make this a one-run game with his fifth home run of the postseason. Hit 19 during the regular season. Now Rick Honeycutt and Dave Roberts talk it over. There's the curveball for strike two.
Yeah, that's better feel, and that might have been part of the conversation saying, let's spin a few more of these and change at least the eye level and the radar in the guy's mind that the fastball looks so much firmer after seeing a curveball like that.
Thank you. 93 mile an hour fastball.
You know, it was almost bound to happen. Everybody that has really towed the rubber, again, with the exception of Darvish, because that's not the typical outing, has been so good. And all the starters have been locked in. This is a game where that has not been the case. The command has not been on both sides where each pitcher would like it. And it is foul. Consequently, it's been a grind, and it turned into a grind for Kershaw after the long inning. And the Astros put up a four spot and tied the game, and then another long inning. Dodgers put up three. He's one out away from breathing easier. Only four swings and misses for Kershaw.
Game one of this World Series with Keuchel and Kershaw went 2-28. We're at 2-21 already in game five.
Outside.
And it's a 2-2 count now. We're only in the fifth. Look at the pitch count for Kershaw. Up to 90.
Yeah, you get the sense that this is going to be it. Maeda's been warming up, and the pitch count has taken its toll. He's trying to get through the fifth.
52nd pitch of the last two innings coming here. Bregman. Another foul.
But the Dodgers twice now have zapped this crowd. The first inning and the top of the fifth.
Because of the way the Astros lineup is set up with these right-handed bats. Maeda in the heart of the order to follow Bregman either now or next inning. Get loose. That is foul. AJ Hinch has right-hander, 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 right-hander. First five spots in his lineup. Two hitter Alex Bregman. Another 2-2 full count.
There's the time in between innings. There might not have been in game one anything longer than 5 minutes. That's a long time
for a guy who spent 5 weeks on the DL with a bad back. Runner at first goes. 3-2 is down. Ball four. And the tying run will come to the plate. And Clayton Kershaw is going to be surprised, I believe, to turn around and see Dave Roberts.
I think he knew once his infielders were gathering around him, that was going to be it.
Well, the Astros have knocked out Clayton Kershaw. If there's no surprise in coming out in the fifth, there is certainly disappointment for Kershaw. Maeda coming in. Altuve, the tying run. Coming up. Clayton Kershaw had a 4-0 lead. He throws 94 pitches. He cannot get the win. He leaves with runners on at first and second, two out, and Jose Altuve coming up. It gives way to Kenta Maeda, who's been so good this postseason out of the pen.
He has been, but you got to wonder how crisp will he be after all the pitches he threw a couple games ago.
Ball has played up since going to the bullpen. Gets the first pitch past the bat of Altuve. after he went 2 2/3 innings, allowed only one hit through 42 pitches here two nights ago. Runners on at first and second, Springer and Bregman.
Everything will typically be away, as you would imagine, against Altuve. Those are sliders. Fastball velocity, as you said, Joe, is up out of being out of the pen. More adrenaline, less work.
Ken Rosenthal reported at the start of the night, Brandon Morrow likely not available after working every game in this World Series. So a thinner bullpen for the Dodgers. Heads down. 2-1.
I've been impressed with the offensive approaches in tonight's game, meaning aggressive counts, but there haven't been a ton of aggressive swings. They haven't expanded the zone. They're waiting for a particular pitch. And when they get it, most of the guys have been able to square it up.
Altuve waits for a 2-1 from Maeda. 2-2.
Altuve would like to have that one back for sure. This one did not break where he wanted it to. Spins out on his heel. You've seen him slip a few times trying to take a big cut. Tension and pressure. That's what this game's been filled with. And when you have those moments, you try to make perfect pitches. And a couple of the sliders are not close enough for Altuve to swing at. I almost think he's got to go right back to a slider, though, on the 3-2 count. Spun, overcorrected it, pulled it without the turn in the zone. Where he threw it, he's lucky he didn't turn, because Altuve would have kept that ball fair. Watch it come out of his hand. It's just spinning. It almost backs up. Whenever a catcher takes his glove the other way, that's a bad sign when it's a slider.
Altuve, open stance, waits. Another 3-2 and a high fly ball deep left center field. At the wall, tie the game. Unbelievable! Altuve, 7-7.
trust the slider, went to the fastball, and this is a guy that doesn't miss fastballs, especially in that spot, to the deepest part almost of the park. The smallest guy went big.
After hitting 24 in the regular season, Altuve's got 7 home runs this postseason.
Unbelievable. And again, just the amount of pitches and Maeda just a tick off in his sharpness, and you can understand it.
Here's Forsyth. Tough play. Wild throw. The throw out of play down to second is Correa, the go-ahead run.
Spin right there. See that turn, and he reaches for it. And that reach right there, and the good speed of Correa, the ball goes thrown into the runner. A hard play for a left-handed first baseman.
Goes down as a single, and then an error on the throw by Forsyth.
Can't make this stuff up. 2 walks in the previous inning, 3-run homer. 2 walks in the bottom of the 5th, and a 3-run homer. Difference is, we're 2 outs.
Now Yuli Gurriel takes a strike. There's action for the Dodgers in their bullpen. I mean, the Dodgers and the Astros have each put up 7 runs. Keuchel was going for the Astros. Kershaw was going for the Dodgers. And they weren't good enough.
The Dodgers bullpen's better, but the Astros bullpen's fresher. The problem is, AJ doesn't really know where to go in some of the freshness of that bullpen because he has not seen the normal activity he's seen in a regular season from some of his guys.
With 2 out, Gurriel fouls it. So Kershaw lifted after the walk to Bregman. Bregman really battled him. And the reaction by Kershaw when that ball left the park. Off the bat of Altuve. Gurriel on 0-2, grounds one left side. Seager, long throw, and he got it.